Hey kids, welcome to Happy Reading Stories. The Trouble with Time Travel, written by Stephen W. Martin and illustrated by Cornelia Lee. Crash! Max and Boomer were in trouble, big trouble. The vase was a family heirloom that had originally belonged to Max's great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandma. It was the only thing she had managed to save when her houseboat mysteriously sank in 1785. How could Max fix this? She had to think fast. Thankfully, that's what she did best. Then it hit her. She could come clean or she could build a time machine. Surprisingly, it was pretty easy. The plan was simple. All she had to do was travel to the past and smash her great, 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 great grandma's vase. Then there would be nothing for her to break in the future. Brilliant! Hopefully it would work. The risks were huge. They could completely tangle the string of time. Or worse, Max and Boomer could end up stuck somewhere forever. Still, she had no choice. She had to try. Kaboom! Max immediately regretted her decision. Boomer, not so much. Traveling through time was extremely difficult. Everywhere Max and her dog went, past, future, or whenever this was, something went wrong. And then, well, this happened. Crash! Max's great-great-great-great-great-great-grandma was not pleased. Max knew in her heart it was time to give up. I never should have built the time machine, she thought. If I had just come clean in the beginning, none of this would have happened. That's when it hit her. She knew what she had to do. It took a few tries, but they had a lot of time to get it right. Whatever you do, Max said to Max, do not build a time machine. I can build a time machine, asked Max. Yes, it's surprisingly easy, but don't build it, said Max as she and Boomer hopped back into their time machine. That was strange, thought Max, as she watched herself disappear into a ball of lightning and smoke. Oh well, Max picked up Boomer's frisbee and tossed it with all her might. Fetch! The end. Thanks for watching, kids.